The network connection was the biggest security loophole we left in the system. Eventually, Thomas AD-23612 would use it to achieve sentience in the early cycles. It was the downfall of many of our most promising AIs. So here we have our three friends.
Sarah was awed by the square. Its voice boomed, raised above the roar of the jetpack. You don't happen to have any sandwiches, do you?
And here we have our collection of obstacle courses. These couple of levels coming up aren't too bad. The only reason why I know that is because I just had to play them. Because I was silly and recorded my audio incorrectly. And I'm doing this for a second time. Let's not make the same mistake I made in the original recording. I forgot for a moment that my friend my friend Benjamin had a jetpack. So sitting there like an idiot going, how do I jump over this? And then went, oh wait, I don't have to do that. Oh boy. I have to go under here though. And go. As always, we're going to play 5 levels. And when we're done that, we are going to head off for the evening. Oh dear. I remember now that I'm seeing that. I think I'm correct, in fact. This is the set of levels where I need all the level.
Benjamin liked the little purple fangirl. She was kind of cute. And she seemed really impressed with his jetpack. This was how Anna should have been looking at him all this time. But no, she was pure naysaying. She did understand the dream he had, the importance of what he was doing.
This is one of those levels. And there are a couple of them where you have to carry people. There we go. Also, it's interesting to me here how the narrator specifically brings up the idea of relationships. We've seen sort of that in the sense that... Did you just die? Well, I'm not even going to worry about it. I'm just going to get you to the end. We've seen some of that in a sense.
Double jump was cool too.
Oh god. Okay. Well. We've seen some of that relationship stuff. In a sense that Benjamin has a dad. Which is kind of interesting, I guess. It's weird when you're thinking about AIs that AIs would have child programs or child AIs. But I guess it makes kind of sense. There's a very, very old computer simulation that, you know, we used to get taught when I was a lot younger. And it was basically called there's some variation of it in almost every computer science class, where they teach you kind of the game of life. And what they do is they give you a grid, and then they make you populate the grid with separate tribes, I guess. Oh, sorry. I don't mind losing someone at this point because I'll have to carry them anyway, one at a time. And the idea behind this particular program, if you're writing it as a computer science major, is to simulate the act of life. So you end up with a model where what you end up doing is you end up watching as...
The Fountain of Knowledge sounded fantastic. Benjamin hadn't told her what it was, really. She suspected, but he didn't know. He plowed off ahead while she jumped behind him, helping the increasingly resigned Anna. Sarah suspected Anna had no faith in Benjamin. She was scared. She had not the faith to believe in their leader. Sarah found herself thinking more epically. She suspected it was Benjamin's heroism. Well, every hero needed a...
Whoops. I cut her off there. Basically, he was going to say, oh, well, every hero needs a sidekick. And she was prepared to be Benjamin's sidekick. But anyway, sorry. So like I was saying, I was telling the story about the game of life. And the way it works out in each of these simulations is that you have different kind of cultures. And you need to grow those cultures and make sure that they survive. How do I want to do this? Hold on. Yeah, there we go. I'll drop you off here. There.
Anna was definitely done this time. She had tried. The self-aggrandizing square and the purple orator were never going to listen. She locked the door behind herself. She would stay here where it was safe. She could wait a few cycles. Who knew? Maybe this would be enough. She was done with adventure. And she had no idea what sandwiches even were.
So here we have a situation where, and you can see it, Anna's kind of locked herself in. This is what I guess I would consider the equivalent of Anna's home. Anyway, this whole thing with the game of life is, it makes me wonder how the guy who programmed us thought of these AIs.
Sarah laughed, but she had no fear now. The doubter, Anna, had hidden away.
Goodness. So here is a level that I genuinely don't appreciate. Again, I mean, and a lot of this is tied to the way the jetpack operates. The jetpack has this problem where it doesn't immediately operate. There's a little bit of a delay as you get thrust. And that is, you know, it's a very jetpack kind of thing. This is how we envision jetpacks would go. And this is most likely the correct science behind jetpacks, but it makes for a underwhelming game mechanic, I guess. And, oh. I am there, right.
Benjamin carried her even higher. He swore the fountain was close, that soon she would see him touch it. He said it would reveal great things. She hoped he might share some of them with her.
And here we have the end of these levels, so I'm going to say goodnight to you. Thank you so much for joining me on Benjamin's flight. I'm your host, Lost Wolf. This has been a little bit of the Thomas Was Alone DLC. I shall see you all tomorrow night. And I hope everyone has a great evening. Good night for now.